Hi everyone, in this lecture we will learn about some important set of data tools that will make your data more meaningful and help you get more information out of your data. The first tool is data sort. This helps arrange the data in a particular order. If your data has text, it will help order it alphabetically or in reverse alphabetic order. If it contains numbers, you can arrange them from smallest to largest or from largest to smallest. Let us apply data sorting on this table. First, select the column you want to sort with. I want to arrange them according to their marks in maths in descending order. That is, the highest scorer should be first. So select maths column, go to filter and sort in home menu. You can also find this option in data menu. Select sort and filter. Select sort largest to smallest. You see the option of either expanding the selection or continuing with same selection. If we continue with same selection, students will stay in the same order, that is student 1, student 2 and so on, but their marks will be sorted. This will assign wrong marks to the same student. Let's try this once. You can see that now student 1 has scored 100 marks, whereas earlier student 1 had scored some other marks in maths. We will undo this. Do Ctrl Z. We will use the option of expanding the selection while sorting. So go to sort largest to smallest, continue, expand the selection, sort. Now we can see that student 4, who actually scored 100 marks, is now on top, whereas student 5, who scored the lowest, is now at the bottom. We can similarly sort from smallest to largest. We will sort student basis their English marks from lowest to highest. Let's do it. We can see student 5 is now in first row with lowest marks and student 1 is in last row with highest marks. To do alphabetical ordering, we select the table below. Go to sort and filter. Click on sort A to Z. The table is sorted alphabetically basis the content in first column. To sort from Z to A, select the other option. You can see that the order is reversed. In this first table, when we sort students basis their maths marks, student 2 and 3 will be having same marks. Let's sort them first. Since student 2 and 3 have same score, which is 85, they come at position 3rd and 4th and Excel keeps them in the same order as before. But if you want to give another rule, that is, if you want to say that this should be first sorted basis math score and then by science score, you can do this by using custom sort. Go to sort and filter, select custom sort. First, tell it to sort by math score, which is already there. Then add a level, select science, and then in descending order, largest to smallest, click on OK. You can see that student 2 is now in fourth position below student 3 because of lesser marks in science. Next, we look at the filtering options. Filters will allow you to keep and filter out the data you desire. That is, if you have data of both male and female and we want to look at the data of females only, you can put a filter on gender and select females only. In our example, we first select the table on which we want to apply filters. Now, you can either go to sort and filter and select filter option, or we can just use the shortcut Alt, then A, then T. You need not press them simultaneously, just in order Alt, A, T. You see these small triangles, clicking which will give us options. In options, you can see that we can also sort the table from here also. Now to simply put a filter, you can go and select or deselect the numbers shown below. So if we want to keep only 99 and 100 scored student, we deselect all the other options and click on OK. Only these two students remain. All the other three rows are now hidden. You can also use the search option. If you have a large data, you can search the particular value and click on OK to keep that particular filter. One thing we can observe is if we apply a filter of say 99 and 100, you can see that small triangle has changed to a filter symbol. This tells us that which column has actually filter applied on it. Another thing to observe is if the column has numbers, the option when you click the small triangle says number filters, and if the column contains texts, the option says text filters. So let us first go through the number filters. We select the small triangle on maths marks. There are several number filters available. These are self-explanatory. You can either specify a number which equals the data or does not equal the data, or you can specify a number for which the data should be greater than that particular number or less than that particular number. For our example, we will use the greater than filter. Let us click on greater than. Maths is greater than 80. What this will do is it will keep the data only of students who have actually scored more than 80 marks. Similarly, we can look at the text filters. In text filters, we have fewer options which say equals or does not equal, where we can give a particular string and it will match if that string is exactly same in our data set. The other option is begins with or ends with, where it will just check that the data in the column actually begins with the string that we have provided. Similarly, there's a contains option which says that all those rows of data will remain which contain the string that we have provided. I will suggest you to explore these on your own. If the column contains both numbers and alphabets, custom sort filter can be used, as it shows both options of text filters as well as number filters. For now, let us just put a custom filter on maths marks only. Let us go to custom filter, and first we will put a greater than filter of 75 marks and a filter of less than 90 marks. So only one student who has actually scored between 75 and 90 is remaining in this data. Other students have been hidden. Next up is data validations. Data validation is used to prevent wrong inputs during data entry. Suppose we float a sheet to gather customer or student data. We want certain validations, such as phone number field should contain only numbers, date of birth should not be older than 1920, etc. So how to apply such validations? First, select the cell on which you want to add validation. So if we are adding a new subject scores here, we want these cells to have numerical values between 0 and 100. So select these cells, go to data, click on data validation. In the allow drop-down option, select whole number and mention minimum as 0 and maximum value is 100. Click on OK. Now whenever we will try adding a larger number, it will give us some error message. Let us see. Excel is giving us this error which says this value does not match the data validation restrictions defined for this cell. If we retry and enter a genuine number, that will be allowed. Similarly, for the name of subject, if we have a fixed list of subjects, we can give a list validation. To do this, go to that particular cell and Click on data validation. Now in allow, select list. In the source option, you can either mention all the subject list comma separated, or you can go and select the list in the Excel sheet that I have created. Click on OK. Now you can see a small drop down option in this particular cell. If you click this option, you can see all the subjects as a drop down. You cannot enter any other value for this cell. Only this drop down value can be selected for this cell. Another check that can be applied is on the length of input characters. For example, if the student name cannot be more than 10 characters, we go to this cell, go to data validation, allow text length and a maximum value of 10 characters. Okay. So now if we try to enter 11 characters, it will give us this error prompt. In the data validation options, two other tabs are also available. These are the input message and error alert tabs. Input message will be displayed when the user is inputting the data, and error alert comes up when user has already broken the rule that we have defined. Let us customize these two messages and see. For input message, we give a title of and for error alert, title will be error in data entry and message will be please enter score between 0 and 100. You can choose the icon that you want to get in the error message. I'll use the warning sign. Okay. Now in this cell, you see that the whenever this cell is selected, the input message will be shown, and whenever you break the rule, so probably I forgot to mention the rule. Let's go and mention the rule first. Allow whole number between 0 and 100. Let's check if the input message is still there. Yes, error alert is still there. Okay. Now let us enter 110. Enter. This is the custom message that we told it to show. Error in data entry, please enter score between 0 and 100. Next is text to columns. A lot of times we get comma separated or tab separated data, or just join data without any spaces. Since keeping data like this takes up less space, the file size is small and there is no limit on file size also. But when you are working on it in Excel, you want different parts of data in different columns so that you are able to work on it. Excel helps you move this text in table format. Let us see how. For student 6 data in our notepad file, we can see that the data is comma separated. If we copy paste this data in our Excel sheet, this comes in one single cell. To move this data into the right cells, select this cell and go to data, select text to columns. You can see two options here. Delimited is where data is separated by a particular separator, such as comma here. Fixed width is used where there is no separator, but we know exactly the number of characters that each column should contain. So here we will use delimited option. Select comma. You can see the separating lines that Excel has created for us to preview. Click next. Click on finish. You can see that the data is now in the correct cells. Let us do the same for other students also. So again, for student 7, data is separated by a star symbol. Now we again go to text to columns option, delimited, next, others, specify the separator, which is star, next, finish. Okay, this is also done. Similarly, for the other two students, there is no particular separator, but we know the column length for each set of data. Let us see how. X two columns, fixed width, next. You can add or remove these separating lines. To add a line, click at the desired position. You can delete a line by double clicking on it. You can drag and drop a particular line to move it. Click on next. Okay. Data is now in the respective cells. This was text to columns. Next is the option of removing duplicates from data. So many times the data has same entries several times. We may want to remove these same entries. In our data, we can see that student 2 has two entries, student 5 has two entries, and student 3 also has two entries. Some of these entries are exactly same. For example, student 2, the maths and marks is science and English, all three are same in both the entries. So we may want to remove such duplicates. Let us do this. We first select the data, go to data and select remove duplicates. One thing to note here is there is a checkbox which says my data has headers. Since our data has the heading of students, maths, science and English, we have ticked this option. In case there is no header in our data, we can untick this option. So to remove exact duplicates, for example, the student 2 that we discussed, which has same marks in maths, science and English, we will select all the columns and click on OK. We see that two duplicates have been removed and six unique values remain. Still, student 5 has two values. For student 5, we want to keep only that entry in which student has scored more marks in English. So let us select the table again and we will sort this data by the marks in English from largest to smallest. Now we will remove the duplicates in this data. This will remove the second entry of student 5, which has lesser marks in English. So uncheck all the other columns, just keep student name and click on OK. That one duplicate value of student 5 has been removed, and you see that the one with lesser marks in English has been removed and the other entry still stays. That's all for this lecture. In next lecture, we will learn about formatting options in Excel. Thanks.